Okay, let's get cracking with deleting a job. So we're going to add just a little text element beneath the save here that will only be visible when the parent group's job is not empty. Okay, so you're not going to see the delete option when you're first creating a job. Wouldn't make sense. So let's grab some text and the visual elements and just drop it beneath button save. That will say delete on body medium, and let's center align the text. In the layout tab, no min width, no min height. We do want to fit width to content, and we do want to put it in the center horizontally. So on the layout tab, it's not going to be visible in page load, and it will be collapsed when hidden to remove that vertical height. And on the conditions tab, let's define a condition for when to show it. And it's going to be very basic. It's just when the parent group's job is not empty. So if we're editing a job, the job exists, and we're going to give them the option to also delete the job at that stage. That's when it's visible. Okay, and because this is a destructive workflow, you always need a confirmation, because a user might just slip of the finger, click that by mistake. It could be catastrophic if they've had multiple applicants on a job, high pressure situation. Okay, so double confirmation. For that, we're going to build a separate pop-up. So we're going to close this pop-up down. We're going to hide it. Let's add a new one. Containers. There it is there. Let's name it delete job. It's going to be a column, and we're going to make it, it's going to be small. Let's make it 360. And the height, just about 200 for now. Okay, I'm just going to copy across the header from the previous one. So if you open up pop-up job, just go ahead and command C and then open up pop-up job and command V. Okay, so we have an issue. It says that the parent group's thing doesn't exist, and that's because on this pop-up delete job, we need job data. Job, fine. This will now say delete job. Over here would say, are you sure you want to delete this job? All right, we can actually remove the conditionals for these guys, for that text element and this text element that came across when we copied it. So are you sure you'd like to delete this job? I'm going to make this pop-up touch wider, guys, so 380. Just want that text in one line, perfect. Now we're going to actually print the job in here, okay? So let's insert dynamic data and say parent group's jobs title. And I want that to be a body large. Center align that. On the layout tab, no min width or min height. Click back on the pop-up. Let's add some gap spacing. 20. So that's the name comes across. And now we need the delete button. So click the button, drop it inside the pop-up. Let's change the style to, so we don't have a destructive button style. So we need that. Okay, so I'm going to detach the style of primary. I'm going to change the background color to red. In the conditions tab, I'm going to say when it's hovered, I'm going to change it to red, and I'm just going to drag this down a touch so it's a bit darker. So 9A0505. And I'm going to remove this condition. Okay, now we can say delete. I And let's just also create a style here. Destructive button and create. And let's just on the layout tab, make sure it's edge to edge, 44 pixels in height. Okay, so deleting is very straightforward, folks. You'll be pleased. So add a workflow. Now we'll go to data and things and delete thing. And simply all we do, because we're deleting a row in the database, and within that row, all of the fields are contained. So it's just the row that we have to point it to. Parent group's job. How simple is that? And once we've done that, obviously hide the popup delete job. Still a few more things to do though. One of them is on this X, when we close this delete job, start edit the workflow, hide an element, hide popup delete job. Okay. And now we have to get data from one popup to the next popup. So open up popup job. Click on the delete text element and click add workflow. Because this time we're going to go to element actions and display data. We're going to display data into the popup delete job. We're going to get the data from the parent group's job. We're then going to hide the popup job and show the popup delete job. So we've pushed data from one popup into the next popup. Could we also use URL parameters or states to get the desired functionality? Yes, we could. Okay, multiple ways to do this. Okay, let's try it. Let's just delete the first job, no code developer. Let's choose delete. Delete job. Are you sure you'd like to delete this job? No code developer. Delete. And it's gone. And that's it. Now, for the next few minutes of this lesson, I'd like you to go ahead and create 3 new jobs. Okay, I'll do the same, but I'll probably fast forward just to speed up the experience. Name it anything you like, something related to tech, maybe something related to no code. All right, guys. So yeah, I created a senior developer, no code developer, bubble UI designer, and a backend engineer. All right. When we get back, we're going to look at the filtering and search option. Very basic what we've built, but useful nonetheless. I'll see you in the next lesson.